Turning now to the high-profile murder trial of three white men charged in the death of a 25-year-old black man, Ahmaud Arbery. We are now on day 7 of the jury selection process, and some say the end is in sight. Kaylee Tracy has been following this case from the start and joins us from Brunswick with the latest on the timetable.
I heard some optimism earlier today from Travis McMichael's defense attorneys, Bob Rubin and Jason Sheffield. They tell me they're hopeful they can get to that magic number of 64 potential jurors qualified by this Friday. Jury selection started 45 minutes late this morning because two jurors were running late. One brought to the courthouse by sheriff's deputies. Defense attorneys asking the judge this morning if they could start promptly at 8:30 each morning and shift jurors who are late to another day. The judge said no, adding, quote, "We burn more time talking about things in here than we do waiting on the late juror." Attorney Sheffield says he and Rubin say a 2-week timeline for jury selection is not unreasonable at all, considering the amount of publicity this case has received.
When those people show up to court and they have opinions that could favor the state or the prosecution more, we have to dig down into that. And so it does require that we sort of stand tall, that we ask those questions that will arrive at those opinions and beliefs, because if we don't do that, if we make assumptions, the danger becomes that we wind up having people on the jury who are not right for this case because they feel too much about the case, whereas jurors who say, you know what, I see that this is a tragedy, but I don't know the facts and how it relates to the law. And that's where we're getting at, and it does take time.
When asked about a change of venue for this case, Sheffield and Rubin say they are hopeful that that will not be the case because so many potential jurors, they say, have already qualified. Reporting in Brunswick, Kaylee Tracy.
Kaylee, thank you. We have in-depth looks at what's happened leading up to the court case and also sharing updates for you on 11alive.com.